Look, Marshall McLuhan said a medium surrounds a previous medium and turns the previous medium into an art form, as television did with film. When film started out, it was peep shows. You know, it was a cheap, you know, penny entertainment. Mm-hmm. By the time television came out, films had turned into a full-blown art form, and certainly by the time television proliferated, the 70s in the film world were a golden age of artistry in a big medium like that, a big commercial medium like that. Well, now the internet has surrounded television and turned television into an art form. All the junk exists out on the internet, you know. In television, you have this, starting, I suppose, with The Sopranos and The Wire and Breaking Bad and on, there's a golden age of television drama now. So, you know, there are interesting things happening there, but there's also the conflict of a medium that's driven primarily by advertising. So that seems to be the rub. Seems to me to be that if you're creating something to keep people docile enough to sit through the ads that are going to come a few minutes later to get to the next part, then I believe you're doing something. That's not how I want to be spending my time. I don't want to be spending my time selling people things they don't need. I'll tell you, this is what this movie's about and what my life is about at this point. You know, we have defined ourselves in this country through music for centuries, since the beginning of the country, since the Star Spangled Banner and the Revolutionary War, you know. Mm-hmm. We've defined ourselves through music, and especially because through films too. This is where films came in. Because we had all these different countries converging on this country to try to form a new nation, mm-hmm. one out of many, you know. Music became the currency that people, even with different languages, could agree on. This is a great song. Films too, it gave people a common language. So these are our art forms, film and music. And as the countries progress, we went from the Revolutionary War to the Civil War. We had John Brown's Body and the Battle Hymn of the Republic. We defined ourselves through music, and we taught everything. You know, music for centuries, all knowledge was taught through music. History was taught through music. Language was taught through music. Mathematics was taught through music. So there was this old our world music, in fact, that was coming from all over the place, but it was all the same thing. It was the music that carried history and knowledge in it, that came up from the person, the common man, mm-hmm. Walt Whitman, you know. And that was part of it too, Thoreau and Whitman and all of that. So we've got this stream, this river going through the country of this music, and we've tried to, you know, the reason 500 Miles is such an important song, an American folk song, is because it's everyone's story in this country. I got a shirt on my back, not a penny to my name, I can't go home this way. The indentured servant in New England in the Revolutionary times, and the black servant in the South in the Civil War times. There's all this dislocation that we're all trying to overcome and to create a new home for ourselves, a new place that we can all be proud of and live in with safety and with our whole hearts. Well, now we live in a time where we're having to face the fact that the United States outlawed slavery within our own borders, but we still practice it all around the world. Every one of us in this room has several slaves working for us to make the stuff we wear, to make the gasoline we put in our cars, to make the energy we, you know, drive our whole country with. So what was once a purely American phenomenon now is becoming more global. So as we go into the past and into the future at the same time, as we go backward and forward at the same time, we have to go tribal and global at the same time. We have to go in these two opposite directions. So for me, what this is about is we in this country have to begin to look into the skull of who we really are. And we have to decide, are we going to face reality and look at the fact that we are still practicing slavery, that this dislocation is going on all over the world now. It's not just us. Because now the whole world knows what we're talking about, can we really talk about American exceptionalism when our exceptionalism depends on people around the rest of the world suffering so that we might be exceptional? We better stop talking about how lucky we are to be free when the people around the world are thinking how unlucky they are that they're having to not be free so that we can, you see? So now this struggle in the age of the electronic universe, this struggle becomes not a civil rights struggle in the United States as it was in the 1960s when this film was made, but a civil rights struggle worldwide.
Mm.